the shots. I take some scenes from my short film and break down the thinking, creative process, and some techniques that involved. Share my experience on how to make the shot look more cinematic. In today's talk, it's about how to make realistic cinematic camera in Unreal. Picking the right camera placement, lens, movement is crucial in making CG content real. We talked about camera lens in the last video. Click the link above if you haven't seen it. In this scene, the pilot's ship is in trouble. I want to put the audience inside his shoes to really understand his situation just by the visual language. And the animation is very easy, but camera framing and the composition is what makes the shot look cinematic. Here, I put all the focus on our character, use a 50 to 70mm lens to compress the space and really put the audience with him. The longer lenses help to compress more space around the character, show less interior, and direct the audience's attention to him. While animating the camera, think about how would a real camera operator move in that space. Is it going to be on a crane, drone, or handheld? If the movement can't be replicated in real life, it might compromise the realism. And try to put the camera to places that make sense in the environment. And treat the camera as another actor. Apply the same animation principle, use the motion to sell the weight of the camera. Quick example, the spaceship drops suddenly. The camera operator might need a slight delay in tilting down the camera to catch up with the motion. And this mimics how a real scenario will play out. So delay the motion just a touch so the camera feels heavy. Camera shake. Adding a bit of camera shake will keep the camera look alive, but be very careful with the roll motion on Z axis. It will make the audience dizzy, and not many camera shake will move like that. And if you can, try to use the mocap for the camera shake. Get it from either the marketplace or use the virtual camera to capture yourself. You can package your camera shake clip into a camera animation sequence. Overlay that onto your base camera motion to avoid cluttered keys. Also, you can adjust the amplitude of rotation and translation for the shake layer. In today's bonus tip, I would love to share a blueprint I used to add more realism to the render side of Unreal. It's called Lens and the Film Post Process. And my favorite feature from it is the subtle blur around the edge of the frame. So it mimics the lens artifacts or lens profile observed in some anamorphic lenses. Also, it can soften up the chromatic aberration to make it look a lot less artificial. Color adjustment is very unique as well. I use it to push the skin color sometimes just a little bit, make the character face stand out, and save one step, color correction step, in the post.